Hey y'all, I just got out of the doctor's office and she checked on my foot and she looked at the x-rays and yay, it's not a stress fracture. After I described the pain I was in, at first she was worried that it could be a developing stress fracture, even though it wasn't showing up on the x-rays. But after I described the pain I was having, she came up with the result that it was peroneal tendonitis. So she told me that she thought that when I asked her if I could run, she really debated on it for tomorrow's race. She really debated on it, and I told her, said, I will walk if you want me to walk. And she said, no, go ahead. You just need to realize that running is hard on your feet, whether you weigh 189 pounds or whether you weigh 3 pounds. It is hard on your feet. So just know that you're going to have to deal with these pains from time to time. But it is good to go ahead and come in and see me whenever you're feeling these pains, because we don't want a stress fracture to happen. So you want to work through these pains, but work through them with caution. So she wants me to, tomorrow before my run and any long runs, to take 2 Tylenol. She would really like for me to take some anti-inflammatory pills like Advil or ibuprofen or something, but she knows I can't have that. So she said 2 Tylenol, and then she went ahead and wrote a prescription for me, but she gave me a sample of Voltaren gel. Theresa, I don't know if this is the same gel that you have, but it's an anti-inflammatory topical, and she said to use this 3 times a day during my long runs. So I need to apply generously before my run, and then after my run, and then later on in the day. She also said ice, 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 so, which is what I've been doing already anyway. But she said she was so proud of me, and it wasn't anything that I did wrong, where I was, you know, maybe running wrong or anything. She says it's just a common runner's injury, and you're gonna get this from time to time. So it was good that I stopped when I did, and that I riced it, which is rest, ice, compress, and elevate. Now when I wrapped it, it did not feel good. So she said don't wrap it anymore, which is, I thought, was good. She also recommended that I go to the running store, which I am going, we're planning on going tomorrow after our race, and ask to get some arch support for my shoes, because this tendonitis, the arch support might help to alleviate some of that pain. So tomorrow after our race, we're going to go to the running, to Red Coyote, our running store, and check that out. I'm going to see if they can have something that they could recommend. She also said that there might be some type of, I can't remember what she said, some extra type of thing that might kind of readjust my left foot to where it's a little bit higher and on the outside, and it might help to alleviate some of that pain as well. We'll see what they say. She said just try the store first, getting some insoles put in. And okay, I'm sorry. So she said to go that route first, and then if for some reason I still am feeling pain in that area after I've done everything after she's told me to do, that she has a really good podiatrist. Her husband's a runner as well, and her husband's family are runners, so she's very well versed in runners' injuries, and I'm so grateful for that, because she will steer me in the right direction. I've never doubted her. She's a family practice physician, but she's been my family practice physician and my daughter's physician since I was pregnant, so 13 years already, and I've grown to trust her. She's a little bit, she's probably like my age, and I won't go to anyone else but her, and I will only go to those that she refers me to. So I trust her, and it's good to have someone that you trust as your physician. So I trust everything that she says. So yeah, I'm so happy I can run tomorrow. I was planning on walking, and Theresa and I had agreed that she would run and I would walk. But, you know, as soon as I start feeling pain tomorrow, I'm going to stop, because I don't want to hurt myself and cause further injury. But the good news is that I can continue running, and that I need to work through this pain and keep communicating with my doctor. So words of advice for y'all, you new runners, because I'm still a new runner. I've been running a year, but I'm not an expert by any means. And all these new pains that come, this was totally different from a regular soreness or tiredness that I've felt in my legs in the past. And I knew I had to go and talk to my doctor about it. So it's not good to let those things go, because you never know. If you're dealing with a stress fracture, she said you're going to be dealing with months of being not being able to run and probably having a boot on. So I'm glad that you came in, is basically what she said. But anyway, that's it for now. She was very happy with my progress, my weight loss, and she's just so happy with the turnaround that I've made. And you know, she's known me for 13 plus years now, and so to see me evolve into what I'm doing now, she even recommended, she said, if you're ever interested in plastics, let me know, because I've got a good plastic surgeon. So I don't know, something we'll have to talk about later. But I know that she would do whatever she had to do to get my insurance approved if I needed to. So it's something we're going to have to discuss later, because I'm absolutely developing some loose skin areas, and and it's more than just loose skin. It's just flab, and it's just gross. And I don't know that I'm ready to put that on YouTube yet, but maybe one day I will. Or maybe I might email some of my YouTube people just in a private message through Facebook or something. Message them with my picture of my lower legs, because that's really bad. It is not pretty, people. Not pretty at all. So Theresa knows what I'm talking about. I've sent her a picture of that. So anyway, that's it for now. I'm talking too long. This is going to be my day 15. I'm halfway through my March Madness. What is it called? My March Madness Daily Video Challenge. All right. Y'all have a great weekend. We'll talk to you tomorrow after our run. See ya. Bye.